Hello all, this is Syed Tosif and today we are going to discuss Laboratory 10 of SciLab, okay, a program of Lab 10 program of SciLab. That is nothing but a binomial distribution, fitting a binomial distribution in SciLab. What are the built-in functions for binomial distribution? And that's going to discuss today, and one program we'll check. Okay, while we are coming to binomial distribution, before that one we just recall some basic concept for distributions. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about statistics distribution, probability we are going to discuss, and where we are going to use in the real world. What are the importance of this distributions, and what are the different types of distributions are there, and finally we'll check the distribution and binomial distribution to program, and we'll convert one program to a program problem to a program. Okay, so we'll quickly start. Statistics, probability and distribution. Okay, first of all, what is statistics? Is nothing but it is a branch of mathematics and science where we are going to collect, summarize and analyze a large amount of data. Okay, what is the use of this summarize, collection and summarize and analyzing data? We will predict some hidden values. Okay, we'll predict some unknown value or some outcomes for some point of time or for some point of value. Okay, even though nowadays we are some technologies we are going to discuss, right? We are currently every day we are going to discuss like artificial intelligence. Our mobile is support artificial intelligence. Okay, so like machine learning concept, as a computer science, we are every day we will discuss about these things, right? How these things are going to be happen with large amount of set of data will be there, summarized data will be there, and analyze we are going to do. Yeah, that is because of this statistics probability. These are basics for this artificial intelligence, whatever the new trend we are going to work, right? Artificial intelligence would be, or machine learning, or we are making some business intelligence we are making. Okay, this all depends on the basic building blocks, we can say probability and distribution. Okay, this will give us a clear point of view to predict some outcomes for some value. Okay, so before going to any more discussion, I would like to ask you guys to take one coin and toss for 4 times. So after tossing it 4 times, what would be the outcomes? Just record that outcomes. The outcome would be you may get tile, head, tile, right? It is a combination. You may get anything. You cannot decide that what would be the next. Okay, so in this one, can we get some percentage of that head will occur this many times? Okay, if I toss a coin for 4 times, okay, what would be the percentage of occurrence of 2 heads? Okay, this is nothing but we are, by using some value, we are giving a question that one. We want 2 heads. What is the possibility of coming 2 heads if I toss a coin 4 times? Okay, for that one, we'll check one simple figure in this one. Okay, in this one, you can check out here the leftmost, we have listed all the possibility outcomes if we toss 4 times a coin. Okay, it would be 4 times continuous head would be there, possibility is there, and possibility is that one 3 heads and 1 tail at the last, and 2 heads, tail, head, tail, and head, tail, head, and these are the possibilities are there, and finally tail, 4 times tail would make, possibility is there. Now we are need to check that one, how many times that 3 heads will or 2 heads will comes. Okay, if we check for 2 heads, you can check out, we just count the occurrence where there are 2 heads are there. Okay, so you can check out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, there are 6 times that 2 heads may occur. okay, this is a one way of considering, means out of six scenarios, six times there is a chance of getting a head two times for tossing a coin four times. Okay, so in this one, if we take, there are different six probabilities, outcomes are there, different six patterns of outcomes are there. So in this one, only six times the probability says that one two heads may come. So that is nothing but this one, 6 by 16, okay, that comes around 0.375, means that one amount around 35 or 37% of percentage is there that two heads may occur for the toss. Okay, the same way, if we consider zero heads should be occur, we are going to check the possibility of zero heads to occur. Now there is only one way of that one, is that one, all four times the tail has to come, right? That is occurs only one, means there is no head at all. So for the x, you can say the count of head we want to occur, okay, need to occur. We are checking for zero, okay, 1 by 6 16, means the total pattern number is, count is 16, and the head is not at all there, means only one occurrence is there. So it becomes 0.00 0.0625. this is the actual probability of zero head occurrence, right? The same way, we have probability for one head occurrence, two head occurrence, three head occurrence, and four head occurrence. But another one thing question arises, this is the simple question is there, okay. Now we are going to discuss a small amount of like four times we are just tossing a coin, and we are directly we can read this one, okay. But remember thing, like if you are tossing a coin 10 times or 20 times, if you tossing a coin, then what type of pattern you will get? A pattern with 1024 counts will be there, means 1024 different patterns will be there, right? If 20 times means it will be more than that one. So if you are going to write a patterns, and if you are going to count the things, okay, it will take a very long time. Yeah, in that case, what we are going to check out for such kind of complex problems, we are going with this, we have some different types of distributions are there, like binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, normal distribution, and every these are things. So might you guys have already gone through this also. We'll discuss what are the required distributions needed for your academy, okay. Now we'll check for some theory. Now in probability theory and statistics, a probability distribution is a mathematical function that provides the probabilities of occurrence of a different possible outcome in an experiment. What is the probability of occurrence of a different possible outcomes in an experiment? In technical terms, the probability distribution is a description of random phenomena in terms of probability of event. What is the probability of event to be occur? Okay, it's a random, we cannot predict, but we can say this much is the probability of occurrence of this event. Okay, statistics is a field of science for collecting, summarizing, analyzing data. Okay, example, what we can say, predicting the result, okay, who will win the result, or probability of winning the cricket match. Nowadays we are getting some bar will be there whenever we go for cricket balls, like that they will show some bar, means saying that one, this is the probability of winning, means 90% India will get win, or 95%, okay. As match goes on, based on the events and the variables, may probability will get changed. Okay, now whenever we comes for a probability or distribution like this, it's purely depends on the random variable. Yes, random variable which we supply. Example, what it would be 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4. We can supply 10 also. We can supply around 1000 also, right? So there's that everything in the probabilities depends on variable. So there are two types of variable. One is a discrete variable, okay, and another one is a random variable. continuous variable. So what is discrete variable? We'll check out what example I have shown here, right, at the in the figure, tossing a coin. It's, we can say it as a discrete, okay, because what is the variable we are using? 0 1 2 3 4. Okay, if you consider 0 to 1, there will be lots of different values. It will might come 0.0001, 0.0002, 0.003 till 1. Okay, but we are not considering these values between 0 and 1. We are just from 0, we are just going for 1. This is called discrete, means they are separate from nature, from each other, right? This is called a discrete variable, discrete random variable. And continuous random variable, as it is the opposite to discrete, we are considering each and every point from one point to another point, from one value to another value. Example 0 to 1, what are the different points can come under these two limits? Okay, it's a continuous, so it is a continuous variable. So we'll check out now how we can define and how we can say this one. Okay, for discrete variable, there is one keyword is there, probability mass function. Okay, and this is denoted by p of x, and p of x is always greater than 0. Okay, you can check out p of x will be always, never it is going to be come to the 0. Okay, it never comes to the 0. It will be always greater than 0. Okay, you can check out for 0 also, it is giving some probability, means if head is not at all coming but tail coming, right? So it is, it will give at least some probability. Okay, and summation of all PMF, okay, probability mass function, it will be always equal to 1. If you add this also, right, you will get one value. Okay, this is called discrete value. How we are going to denote? By using p of x, and p of x is always greater than 0, and summation of p of x will be always 1. Okay, when we comes to continuous, yeah, then we will call it as a probability density function, and denoted by f of x, and it is always greater than 1, and it is calculated in the form of integration, and from the limit, lower limit is minus infinity to the higher limit infinity f of x dx will be always 1. Okay, now we'll check out what are different types of distributions are there for continuous and for discrete. If it comes to continuous, exponential distribution, normal distribution, uniform distribution, and in the discrete, if it comes to discrete variable, binomial distribution, Poisson distribution. Now the question arises, there are many types of distribution which we have to work with, which we have to use for our outcomes, right? It's purely depends on what are the variables we are using, and if it comes checking for variables, so, and how it is, what is the nature of problem, based on that we are going to select any one of the distribution. Okay, now we'll check out a little bit what is random variable and that kind of thing. Random variable is a real value function, right, which assign a real number to each sample. And discrete variable, a random variable, discrete variable is a random variable only, which taken as a finite or more countable number value is called discrete. Example, number of heads for toss. Okay, number of heads might be, we can count for 0 1 2 3 4. Okay, for 4 toss means not more than 4, we can not go more than 4. Okay, defectiveness of item manufacturing for 100 units. Okay, now in the figure I would like to explain the each and every point. Okay, x is the count of h occurs, okay, for the tossing a coin, tossing a 4 time coins. Okay, might be it can occur for 0 time, might be only 1 time head occurs, might be 2 times head may occurs, 3 times may occur, 4 times may occur. Okay, what is the probability of getting these heads? Okay, In this one, whatever the 0, 1, 2, 3 you are saying, right? It is nothing but the discrete variables. That is x. And p of x is the probability distribution. You can check out here 1 by 6 is the probability distribution. And finally, what we are getting the fraction point, that is the distribution. This is the probability, 1 by 16 is the probability, and the combination of this, right? The result of this one is nothing but the probability distribution, combination of variable, okay? Variable that is 0, and its probability is called probability distribution. For 0, what will be the probability? This is called probability distribution, means for 0, we are distributing, this is the probability, okay? So we'll quickly move for binomial distribution. Now we have discussed about distribution and everything. We got the concept that we are determining some outcomes, right? We are just determining the probability of outcomes, okay? Now binomial distribution. Now when to use this binomial distribution? When the number of trials must be fixed. The trial, example, 4 times only we are going to toss the coin, right? Trials are fixed. Each trial must have the same possibility, okay? Example 1 by 2. Okay, we'll check this one. And outcome must be the same or similar. Example, the probability of getting tail as well as head will be the same. Okay, all the trails are independent. Yeah, all the trails are independent. Okay, now this is the formula for binomial distribution. P of x, we know that one. Probability mass function is denoted by p of x, small p of x, okay? You can check out. And the next function is, formula is factorial of n. N is nothing but the trials, okay? Number of trials. X is the number of success desired, okay? Factorial of n divided by n minus x factorial into x factorial. This we can say ncx, right? The combination ncx, right? And p power of x, q power of n minus x. Now in this one binomial distribution, we know that number of trials, number of x is variable. What is p and what is q? Okay, p is nothing the probability of getting success in one trial, and q is the what we say, if negation for the p. Okay, example, if 0.3 is a possibility of success, then 0.7 is the probability of failure. That is nothing but q. Okay, so we can say that one, q is always 1 minus p. Okay, and another one thing, interesting thing is that one, if I am considering x as a possibility, desired possibility of success, then p, x is a desired success, then p is a possibility of desired success, okay? Then q become the probability of failure, getting a failure. If x, if I consider as a desired failure, then p will be act as a probability of desired failure, and q will be the probability of like success, right? It, q is always ulta for the p, right? Yeah, this is the formula. Okay, if you make x for success, then p also probability of success, then q will become probability of failure. If x is a defectiveness or the failureness, then p will become probability of failure and q will become the probability of success. Remember the things. So in future also, if we are making some complex problem using this fiction, we can make a simple, okay? Okay, example, you are tossing a coin, one example, 3 times. What will be the outcome? We have listed, that is nothing but space we call, okay? Space we call, total space we call it as a yes, okay? What is the total space? HHH, HHT, THH, HTH, TTH, TTH, THT, HTT, and TT. These are the possible outcomes are there, okay? That is nothing but you can easily say that one, whatever the outcomes, if you are tossing twice, thrice, then it will become 2 into 2 power 8 means the out space will be 8, okay, the count of space will be 8. If you are tossing 3 times, then 2 power, if you are tossing coin 4 times, 2 power 4, it will become 16. If you are tossing 5 times, then it will become 2 power 5, that is 32. Like thus, the space is going to be increased, okay. Now, find out the probability of getting 2 heads, okay. Now, you can check out. N is 3, the trials are 3, okay. What is probability you want to know? You want to know the probability that you want 2 times hedge, right? By counting also you can give 1, 2, 3, 3 times it will may occur, okay. 3 by 8, if you make it, you will get the probability. But if it is a complex problem, you cannot do that one. So because of that reason, we are just for demo, we are taking a simple problem. For complex, we use this one. Okay, you can check out 3c 2, okay, and 1 by 2 square and 1 by 2. Example, why it is 1 by 2 only? Because the formula is n minus x, n is 3 minus 2, okay, that become once, no need to define that one, right. What is the 3c2 value is 3, okay. 1 by 2 square is 1 by 4, 1 by 2 is equal to 2, that is 3 by 8, the same value we got, right. Yeah, this is a very simple problem. We can count, we have counted and we got the same value, and we have using the formula also we got the same value. Now there are some technical terms in the binomial distribution, that is in not in binomial distribution, in any distribution if you go, there will be some general terms are there. Movement generating formula, MGF, that is denoted as this formula, because this formula, what distribution you are going to use, I believe in gate examination or any examination, for higher examination, sure you will have a problem on this one. So they will ask the problem based on this or this formulas only. Movement generation formula or mean. Mean is nothing but average or expected value, and variance. These are the three formulas are there to find out. But today's context, we are not going to discuss these things. We are going to discuss the binomial problem, and we are discuss one program for the binomial distribution. Okay. Example, out of 800 families with 5 children each, means there are 800 families and each family having 5 children, how many families could be expected? Okay, how many families could be expected? Just find out the probabilities below for the below questions. Having 3 boys, right? Means find out the probabilities that how many families are having 3 boys, having 5 girls, having either 2 or 3 boys. Okay, now we can check out the capital N is 80, but our trial is 5, trial count is 5. So now we can find out P as 1 by 2. Why it is 1 by 2? Okay, what is the actual different types of elements are here? Boy and girl, there are 2 types of different element. Okay, we are going to find out either boy or girl, we are going to find out, that is the count is 1. 1 by 2 always it will be 0.5. if 1 by 2 is the success, then what is the failure? That also become 1 by 2 only. Okay, so this is the things we got. Now we will check our formula. Okay, what is our formula? P of xx pros PMF will get 5cx p power x q 5 minus x. Okay, x is the random variable we can take. Now what we are want to having 3 boys, means we want to check the probability of families having exact 3 boys. So we can directly go for p of 3, right? The then formula become 5c 3 p power 3 and q 5 minus 3. Okay, 5c3 is nothing but this one, 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial, right? Okay, p power x means 1 by 2 power 3 into 1 by 2 power 2. Okay, this leads to the combination, this NC 5C3 will become 10 value. It will give you the 10 value. If you want that one, we'll check out. Okay, just I want to clear this one. Okay, factorial of 5 divided by factorial of 3 into factorial of 2, 10 exactly, right? So just I'm making a short shortcuts for this calculations. So 10 into 1 by 8, 1 by 2 power 3 is nothing but 1 by 8 only we will get, okay? And 1 by 2 power 2 will get 1 by 4. If we calculate this one, we will get like 1 by 5 by 6 output, right? So if we multiply this 1 by 5, then it will give us 250 as a families having 3 boys. So you can check out, might be if you want to do this one, okay, this how many families are there, but with a fraction of second using this formula, we got the probability that 250 families would have 3 boys, right? Now having 5 girls, okay, so like this we are counting for 3 boys scenario, right? Having 5 girls means that one, there is no, having 5 girls means that one, there is no boy, means boy is not there, only the family which having 5 girls, means we can check out the probability for 0 boys, right? If we take the probability of 0 boys, then we will get this value. You got this second point, right? Why we are checking the probability of 0 boys? Because there is no boys means always there will be 5 girls, means around 25 families will have, would have, there is a probability that one, 25 families would have 5 girls and having either 2 or 3 boys. If just check out the families who have either 2 or 3, means nothing but we have to make the sum of PMF of 2, PMF of 3. Okay, if you do that one, we will get this is the value, and after multiplying with 800, we'll get 500 families that one, okay, having either 2 or 3 boys. Okay, this is the way of calculating or predicting some value for a particular moment. Okay, so we'll quickly check out one program also. For that, this program we'll going to check our program also. Okay, now the probability of a man age 60 will live till 70 is 0.65 out of 10, means saying that one, there are 10 men out there. What is the probability of, what is the age of 10 men is 60. Okay, now there is only 6.05% or probability is there this 10 people will reach to the 70. Okay, now using this input, we have to find the probability of 7 men will live till 70. What is, now 10 men is there, but we want to find out 7, we are not going to find out 10 men. Okay, we'll check out probability of 7 men and find the probability of at least 7 men. Here it is saying at least 7 men. Okay, might be 7, 8, 9, 10 men will go. Okay, they are saying that one, at least 7 men will live till 70. Find the probability of exactly 9 will live 70. Find the probability of at most 9, okay, will live 70. At most means what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 9, okay, 9, till 9, this range of possibility, just check out. Okay, now we'll check out. Now n is equal to 10. Yes, there are 10 trials, 10 men is there. Probability is 0.65 is the probability of success, means this is the probability of success that 10 men will reach to the 70 age. But what is the failure probability? That is 1 minus p is nothing but 0.5 is the failure probability. Is that saying that one might be 10 people may not reach to the 70. Okay, now pf of x, it will come 10 cx, 0.65 power x and 0.35 10 minus x. This is the formula we'll get. Now we'll check out for first. Okay, p of 7. Okay, 10 c7, 0.65 power 7, 0.35 power 10 minus 7 is nothing but 3, right? So this is the 10 c7 is equal to 7, and this value it will become this one, and this is the things. 0.25 is the probability of 7 men exactly reaching to the 70. Okay, now the second, for the second problem, the probability of at least seven men will live 70. Okay, now it is saying at least, maybe 8 also would be there, 10 also we have to check for 9, 10. So in this one we have to just make a summation of 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, this it will give like this, and we'll get this value. Okay, if you do the practical you will get it. Okay, then third question is, find the probability of exactly 9 will live till 70. Means we'll put the we'll check the p of 9 and we'll get it. Yes, exactly we'll got it. And here, find the probability of at most 9 will live till 70. Now we have to check the probability of what 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 9, except 10, okay? So instead of that, what we'll do, we will get the probability of 10 and we'll make it from minus, it will make a minus, means we'll check for Q, then we'll get the probability of this one. This is simple, because instead of doing 0 to 9, we'll take the 10 and we'll minus from the 1, okay? For the 10, we'll get this probability. Okay, this is on problem. Okay, now we'll check what is the built-in function there for binomial distribution, and how we can solve this problem in the distribution in a program. Okay, this printf is nothing but, okay, we'll try to execute first and we'll check it whether we'll get the output. Okay, this is graph showing the probability for the each and every values. Okay, so we'll check for output. You can check out, this is a question we are showing probability of men having this and this, find out these values. Okay, question 1, question 2, question 3, question 4. And the same way we are going to display the values. Okay, question 1, it is question 1, we'll make it a question 1. Okay, question 2 is nothing but this one, question 3 and question 4. Question 4 for exactly this one, right? So this is the output of the program. So we'll go for program now. Okay, like this is a number of trials is 10, and what is the possibility of question is 0.65, and for the 0.65 there is a binomial coefficient is there, built-in function, so it will take values p and n, and it will give you the matrix, one row matrix to the input. Okay, so if you can check out what it is doing, what we have discussed, right, that only it is going to work. And not only this one, if you come to this one, you will get a lot of different types of functionality it is there for cumulative distribution function, beta distribution, cumulative distribution. These are the built-in functions for cumulative distribution. If you come to statistics, okay, mean, how to find out the mean, okay, that we have already discussed some formula, not exception formulas we have discussed, right? And quart, computation of quart is, you can check out Poisson also is there, cumulative distribution function, Poisson distribution, cumulative distribution function for student T function. We have program for this Poisson as well as student T distribution. We will discuss that one, but before that one we should have a clear understanding what is distribution, probability distribution and everything. So today we are going to discuss binomial distribution, and we know that one, when to use the binomial distribution. The same way we'll discuss what is a Poisson distribution and how, what is the requirement for Poisson distribution and T, and chi square distribution also might be, we have to discuss, right? Fisher distribution, okay, this is the about distribution. If you comes to help manual, right, we have already discussed this also, how, what are the built-in functions are there. But if you scroll down for differentiation, lots of functionality is there, built-in functionality, and you can do lots of thing. You can perform artificial intelligence using Scilab itself, right? So this is the environment of the Scilab. So we'll come to the program now. This is a one printf function. In this one, the each and every line we are making separate using the slash n. You know the slash n meaning, right? This many times I have used the slash n question, first question one, question two and everything. So I'm just initializing the values. The trial number is n 10, p is this one, and just clearing the functions. You can check out this function, clear and reset figures or the frame, okay, for like if you are using some what we say charts and everything. So using this one, I'm just passing the number and position, probability. We will get all the probabilities for this 10 numbers trials, okay. We just displaying that one, okay. First question is, the first question, find out the probability of 7 men will live till 70. Exactly 7 is nothing but, we just have to take the already we have already calculated the probabilities from 0 to 10. We have to just take the 8. Why we are taking the 8? Because in our scenario it is a 0 to 10, but in Scilab it is 1 to 11, means start index is 0, but in the Scilab start index is 1. So just we are making one increment and we are getting the 7 value. And after that one solution, the second question is, find out the probability of at least 7 men will live. Okay, at least 7 men will live, nothing but p of x plus p of 8 plus p of 9 plus p of 10, right? That we are going to do by this way, right? From I we are taking from 8 to 9, 8 to 11, and we are making the sum and we are just displaying the sum. It's very straight forward functionality. And after that one, ninth one, and in this one you can check out, we are taking the last 10th value. 10th value is nothing but the 11th value, and when we are making minus 1, we are getting this the final result. Find the probability of at most 9 will live, okay. And just we are plotting the graph for 0 to n trials and what is the values for this one, okay. Once again I would like to run the programs. Just I will clear the things, I will run. You can check out the graph is plotted, and again we can check out here also we got the output, right? Yeah, this is lab 10. Even though I'm preparing for laboratory part, like I want to complete a distribution first. So the distribution problems like Poisson distribution is there, chi square distribution is there, and student T distribution is there. So I will share the videos related to that one, and if possible we'll have it tomorrow class. You guys go through this video. If you guys have any doubt, you can comment in the Google Classroom. That time also I will try to give response. and tomorrow session also we'll have a doubt section, so there also we'll discuss this one. Okay, thank you all, and thank you.